For this review, let's take a look at the Nakatsu Studio Roman porno revival movie, Anti-Porno. Kyoko is a young artist and author with a sadistic temper who takes all her anger out on her older assistant Mariko. But as we discover, she is vulnerable after the death of her sister and uses sex as a way to fight back against her strict upbringing. Her way of dealing with this is to take on the role of herself in an adult movie where she wants to be a whore, but struggles with the concept as she's still a virgin. Is it worth watching? Yes, absolutely, and not just for the nudity, of which there is plenty. This is actually a well-constructed, if very weird, movie. By definition, a Roman porno is a pinku film brand of the Nakatsu Film Studio and must contain 4 sexual scenes an hour. Other than that, the directors are given carte blanche to do whatever they want, and in this film, Sion Sono has done just that. The movie breaks the fourth wall regularly to show the film crew shooting Kyoko's porn film, as well as the actresses berating each other. There's even a role swap at the end of the film. The film is set in Kyoko's large but sparse studio apartment, featuring an array of obscure props and characters. This movie is an exploration of Japanese female sexuality, so expect to see a lot of woman-on-woman action and dialogue that discusses this. It has a great ending. The performances of the cast are outstanding and the movie is colourful. The story is a little on the confusing side, so luckily for those who don't quite understand what was going on, there is a detailed explanation from Kyoko towards the end of the film. Enjoy.